Hello students, welcome to Connecting Class to Home e-learning program by DCM Group of Schools. I know some of you may not be having your computer book with you. So the name of your book is IT Vision and name of the chapter is Evolution of Computer. Children, at the end of this video, you are going to learn calculating devices, generations of computer and types of computer. So first of all, we'll talk about the calculating devices. As clear from the name, calculating devices are those which help us in doing calculations. We have different calculating devices, for example, abacus, Napier's Boon, Leibniz calculator, difference engine, analytical engine, ENIAC and UNIVAC. Students, in earlier times when we were not having any computer, we used these calculating devices to perform calculations. The first device is abacus. I know you all are familiar with this device. It was the first device invented in China. As you can see in the picture, it has wooden frame with wires and beads used to perform simple calculations. The second device is Napier's Boon. It was invented by Sir John Napier in 1616. The third device is Leibniz calculator. It was invented by Gottfried Leibniz in 1671. It can do addition, subtraction and can also find square roots. The next is Pascaline calculator. Students, can you see these wheels over the images? These wheels are rotated to display numbers and perform addition, multiplication and division up to thousands. The next two calculating devices are difference engine and analytical engine. Both the devices are invented by Charles Babbage. Difference engine is capable of preparing error-free mathematical tables. Error means mistakes. And analytical engine has three basic elements: input, output, and memory device. The last two calculating devices are ENIAC and UNIVAC. Both were invented by John Maudslay and J. Presper Eckert. ENIAC stands for Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer. It is the first general purpose digital computer. UNIVAC stands for Universal Automatic Computer. It is the first commercial available computer for handling numerical and textual data. Now the next topic is generations of computer. Let me make it easy for you to understand by giving an example. As the man has evolved from a monkey to a human, same is the case of computer. The computer is also evolved from first generation vacuum tubes to the fifth generation artificial intelligence. Now in first generation, input was given by the punch cards, vacuum tube were used. The examples are ENIAC, EDVAC and UNIVAC. In second generation, input were given by the punch cards, transistors were used and output were also displayed on punch cards and magnetic tapes. In third generation, input was given by the keyboard, integrated circuit were used, output were displayed on monitors. Now in fourth generation, input is given by the keyboard and mouse, microprocessors are used, output are displayed on printer, plotter, speaker, etc. In fifth generation, input is given by keyboard, mouse, scanner. Artificial intelligence is used. Output is displayed by the robots. Now the last topic of this chapter is the types of computer. As you can see in this image, we have four types of computer: mini computer, microcomputer, mainframe computer and supercomputer. First is microcomputer. These are the computers which we used in our homes, schools, for example, desktop, laptop or tablets. The second is mini computer. It is bigger in size as compared to the microcomputers. It is used in big organizations like universities, research centers, etc. The next is the mainframe computers. As you can see in this image, it is big in size. They have huge memory. It is used in railway and stock exchange markets. The last type of computer is supercomputer. It is very large in size. It is expensive. It can't be kept at home. It is used in weather forecasting or satellite controls. Students, I hope the concept is clear to you. So stay home, stay safe. Thank you.